But the key principle for antifragility is push decision-making down to where the work is being done. And maybe a good example here, if you are a sports fan and you're a fan of sports cars, whether it's a Formula One or NASCAR or any of them, any of the car races that require you to change tires or to refuel cars, I mean, the ultimate goal of those pit crews is the car screeches into the garage, the crew jumps on that car, and within a flash of seconds, they can have changed tires, replaced a part of the car that was broken, refueled it. It's astounding to watch. But you realize you can't have a boss in charge who's now saying, right, next thing to do is the front left wheel. Each person in that team is absolutely empowered to handle their part of the system. And if something goes wrong, you don't see 10 people jump in to try and solve the problem. If one of the tires gets stuck, it's the person's job who's dealing with the tire to identify the problem, fix the problem. If he wants help, he must call for help. But it's his choice, and he has the authority in that. So it's a sports example, doesn't always translate, but whatever you can do, the third principle here of antifragility is to distribute decision making. It's probably one of the most significant and one of the most difficult for old school leaders to do.